most worthy one. Rest your lack and listen to my stories. That is, if you have nothing more important to do, like saving the world, doing my companion quest, killing monsters, looking anywhere but standing next to you. Such an assisting me in a delicate situation. China gives you a sly wink. I'm not interested. What sort of help do you need? The Vodrani proffers a small scroll. This was written by my father. It was meant for my family that has lived for centuries, near the home of my relatives in Absalom. Life has scattered us all across Galarion. But we never... Wasn't it Galarion? I could have sworn it was with an A. Well, whatever. But we never gave up hope of reuniting with those who once knew so well. My father asked me to pass this letter to a member of this fine family. I should ever happen to stumble across one. As I recently discovered, one of them lives nearby. The noble house of trades in your capital. I confess, I'm too nervous to meet him. I fear that my anxiety will cause me to behave improperly, and I may disgrace myself for it. Would you assist me in fulfilling my duty and deliver him this letter? I do not believe that my heart can be at peace until this letter is delivered. One cannot be master when beset by such destruction. I would like to know more about you, huh? Do I now? I don't. Oh my god. She is turning everything into a story, apparently. Tamya Vudra. No, don't tell me. Keep quiet. You were a ruler. Keep quiet. Let's talk of your homeland some other time. After I shot myself. Do you enjoy living in my lands? This is a wondrous land. You have such strange cuisines and kobolds. Incredible creatures. We do not have them in Vudra. These insolent creatures? Squirrels! I've never seen such fierce creatures. Oh my god. I have to go. Until we meet again. No. Not on my watch. Not if I can prevent that. Jesus. Alright, what letter did she give me? Alright, let's start from here. Letter from Jamandi Aldori. Let me remind you that while the trading post in question is situated on the land which now belongs to you, its owners, Oleg Leventon and his spouse Svetlana are of rest of origin. They've been paying their tax register for many years and enjoying the benefits of blah blah blah. Some debts are owned by Leventon's post, blah blah blah, okay. Just some posturing telling me I have to pay. Invitation from the Kingdom of the Clans, sister and brothers. Take. Okay. Take a step towards a better future, in which there is no place for poison and evil. Look away from false rulers and open your soul to the only goddess. Join the Kingdom of the Cleansed and stand against our common enemy. Upon being cleansed, will you find true faith and peace. Come to the temple at sunset, the temples without walls, filled with love and happiness. Below there are scribbled directions how to get to the temple. Seems that the cultist's secret sanctum is located somewhere in Camelands. Alright, dropping a nuke on that. Someone is exhausted. Alright, Mega Ron's letter. That's the Baron, the other Baron. Most honorable Baron Sam! Exclamation mark. This is Mega Ron, the ruler of the neighboring city of Vornhold, writing. You might remember meeting me at the reception. Our encounter had a powerful effect on me. Oh, friend. You're a brave warrior and a wise ruler. Oh, yes, so. Which is why I hope to enlist your support and in the future from a friend. Oh my god. He just wants something from me, huh? No matter whether the gods or the swordlers have contributed to us becoming neighbors, I believe that our alliance will be as steadfast as a rock. Is he proposing to me? To signify the formation of our alliance, I invite you to visit Vornhold and see for yourself that my intentions are good. The city is still young, but we have a lot to show our guests. Our cellars are full of wine barrels and our stores of grain and cheese. He wants me to get drunk, huh? It is easy to reach my city. The path to Wormhold lies in the east, past Lake Silverstep and over the ridge of the Tors of Livend. How to get lost in these parts? This is like old school Tinder. Whether you accept my invitation or not, I ask of you one more thing. Consider building a route and developing trade between our lands. I'm convinced that both of us would only benefit from this union. I anxiously await your visit. Okay. If someone proposes to me like that, I will take a visit. I will be coming, my friend. Oh, a letter from Cheyenne's family addressed to the family of the merchant Hassov. And it's closed, I cannot read it. That. Alright. Off we go. We don't have to fight too much because these three guys are not even leveled. And they don't have a single gear, so... Alright, so we claimed this one. I forgot I can claim this now. There's one more here. Alright, the next part is this here. To get the... press. The printing press. And it's off to the troll wilderness. I think both Jubilus and Harem want to go there. I'm not wrong. If I read it correctly. Why do I keep getting the end times are nigh, Harem? Why do I keep getting that? Stop it! I don't care. Oh, there it is. Bandits probably, huh? That snow is killing my FPS. It's so bad. Bandit, how did you fools manage to lose the horse? Oh, we supposed to carry these bugs ourselves? What even are these iron things and why the hells do we need them? That's Sam, Lindsay whispers, pointing at the bandits. Cocked red-handed. We showed them what happens when you take someone else's things without... We will teach them a lesson. You stole my money. You little... iron things. These iron things will get us rich, Blockhead. It's an alchemical transmuter. I've seen them in Ustalav. We just assemble it, turn it on, and it turns rocks into gold all on its own. Are you stupid? Don't just stand there. Get in the harness. Jubilus opens his mouth about to say something, but instead just covers his face with his palm and shakes his head sadly. Because there's definitely no machine out of here that could turn stuff into gold. You sure about this then? Alright, let's see if we can even get this wagon to move. Intimidate? You have 10 heartbeats to disappear. Go. Oh, your grace. This shipment belongs to the Baron. What did you get us into, you idiot? Run! I wanna kill them. Alright, whatever. It would be better to kill them, but... whatever. After inspecting all the boxes in the wagon, Lindsay barely restrains herself from kissing the mechanism inside. The press! Safe and sound. Just needs some assembly. Yay! Such infectious enthusiasm. I think I can already offer you a book or two by the famous Jubilus Nathropel. And a few useful recommendations on organizing book publishing. The second one is free. I can't believe it. My own publishing house. I have so many ideas, so many plans. I don't know where to begin. What do you think I should print first? Well, you know, sex sales. If you wanna be really famous, do the fantasy Kama Sutra. What would you like to print? I don't know. That's why I ask you. I mean, it's more than just a business decision, right? It's, well, a choice. First step. Not like my whole career will depend on one book, but always think back on it. Remember when you finally got your own printing press, Lindsay? What was your first printing again? And I don't want to be ashamed of my answer, so it's probably no pawn, huh? Alright. Print something already banned just to spite him. Choose something beautiful. Bokyo wouldn't be ashamed to have your teacher read. The machine needs to pay itself off quickly. Just start with cheap fiction. Romance novels, huh? The quality doesn't matter, but as long as they sell well. I'll choose something beautiful. Lindsay smiles at you warmly. It was teacher who showed me the beauty hidden in books. I think the best way to repay that kindness would be to do the same for others. Maybe that's really the main calling of a bard. Were you looking to waste paper? Well, if Sam lets you, it is your right. Still, you had best print something useful for the citizenry. Not just something pleasant to a handful of intellectuals. Bruh. Let's get to it. I was in for horses to get this delivered the rest of the way to the capital. Very kind of you not to make me bother with that. Oh, let's visit Beldame. We have not been here. Okay, nothing. She doesn't offer anything new? This quarter stuff. So expensive. Still expensive. Well, there's nothing I really care about. I mean, Ring of Protection would be nice to have. Amulet of Natural Armor. But it's so minuscule in terms of what it gives. I don't care. Oh, we could have gone to the capital. Ah, whatever. Well, one quest knocked off. Two more to go. I probably have to build a printing press for her. A building, right? Would be my estimation. Assumption.
My life is a burden.
The end times are nigh. I swear to God, if I read that one more time. Did you be lost? Splendid. I knew you couldn't hide from me forever, you elusive dwarven outpost. Jubilus digs the map out of his pockets and makes a mark on it. That's it. On behalf of all the institution of NSC, I hereby thank you. As a matter of fact, I'm even qualified to reward your help in hard coin. He gets out his purse and throws it at you. 1,800? Nice. Now all I have to do is finish my article for The Independence. About the state of affairs in your barony. Jibu looks at you defiantly. I'll be honest with you. Unfortunately, I can't write anything too good. Lawful evil, kill him. Alright. Well, I won't interfere with whatever you're going to write.